Very good morning, class 12th. So let's continue the chapter which we started from the book Flamingo. Chapter number 5, that is Indigo, written by Louis Fisher. Now Louis Fisher, he met Gandhiji and he wrote a book on him. So this is one part of it. Gandhiji narrated about Champaran district, which is in Bihar. That how Indian peasants, when there was the when Indians were under the rule of Britishers, how Indians faced the problem, how Britishers, Englishmen were exploiting them, the Indian peasants. So Rajkumar Shukla, he was also the Indian peasant. He met Gandhiji because he came to know that he could only help him. He met Gandhiji, convinced him, as Gandhiji was already busy for because he was fighting for the Indian's freedom only. Now they both started their journey towards Champaran district. So from here I am reading now. So they went to Rajendra Prasad place. At that time Rajendra Prasad was not there. His servants were only there. When they looked at Gandhiji, thought the untouchable, the lower caste, made them to sit on the floor and not allowed to fetch the water directly because it seemed that they would pollute the water. Then Gandhiji thought to go to Muzaffarpur to collect information before reaching to the Champaran district because Muzaffarpur will come in between. And there he met met Kirpalani and Professor Malkani. He stayed at Professor Malkani's place for 2 days. And at that time, it was a very extraordinary thing. Because no government official at that time was interested to make Indian freedom fighter to stay at their place. And then when Gandhiji came to know that how the lawyers, Indian lawyers, were charging huge fees from the Indian peasants, he chided them. He scolded them very badly. And then we are going to learn the history of that indigo. So here what happened, Gandhiji, he was not permitted to draw water because it seemed that he would pollute the entire water. How did they know that he was not an untouchable, right? Gandhi decided to go to Muzaffarpur. He gave the telegram to Professor J.B. Kripalani of the Arts College in Muzaffarpur. And there on 15th April 1917, you need to understand, he arrived at midnight. So Professor Kripalani and number of students came to pick Gandhiji. Gandhi stayed there for 2 days in the home of Professor Malkani. As I mentioned, he was a teacher in a government school. And it was an extraordinary thing because a government professor gave shelter. He harbored a man like him. Then the news of Gandhi's arrival, advent, that is, and his mission spread quickly. So number of people from Muzaffarpur as well as from Champaran district, they came on foot to meet Gandhiji, that how a stranger reached to their place to fight for them, right? Muzaffarpur lawyers called on Gandhi to brief him. So Muzaffarpur lawyers, the Indian lawyers, explained the situation to Gandhiji. And they mentioned about their cases and reported the size of their fees. So basically those lawyers, they had filed a case. They were the representatives of Indian peasants because some problem occurred that we will discuss in the history also. So Gandhi chided the Indian lawyers because they were charging the huge money from the Indian peasants only. And he concluded that peasants were so crushed and fear-stricken. Low courts are useless. The real relief for them is to be free from fear. So there he realized that the Indian peasants, they were so afraid from the things. So first priority for them is to make those people free from fear of mind. This is very important. Free from fear of mind. So that fear which was in the mind of Indian peasants, that need to be taken out. They need to be free from them. Now the history we need to understand here, what's the history of this indigo? Most of the arable land in the Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian tenants. So basically seasonal crops were grown there. So at that arable land, Englishmen were ruling on it, those lands belonged to them, and Indian peasants were the tenants, they were working under them. The chief commercial crop was indigo. The landlords compelled all tenants to plant 3/20 or 15% of their holdings with indigo and surrender the entire indigo harvest as rent. This was done by a long-term contract. Now what happened? Englishmen, they forced the Indian peasants, because Indian peasants were the tenants on their land, they compelled them that on 15% land, indigo would grow. forcefully it was told to them. And that land, when you grow indigo, that dye color, that land becomes the wasteful later on. That we can say the barren one. So they were forced to grow indigo at 15%. And when that indigo would grow, that commercial crop, that whole indigo, those 15% indigo, whatever has been grown there, that would be given to the Englishmen as a rent. So whatever they had grown, they were giving it to the Britishers. So basically what's happening? Forcefully they were doing it, and the land was becoming waste also now, because that this indigo was not good for the land, right? Secondly, whatever they were growing from it, they were not able to earn the money, they were not able to sell it in the market, because Britishers, the Englishmen, were taking it. First thing. Presently, the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. They thereupon obtained agreements from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. Now, Englishmen, they came to know that in market there is a synthetic indigo which was produced by Germany. Indian tenants were clueless. So Englishmen thought, now synthetic indigo is in market, it means their hold on indigo in the market is not that much, because people will purchase that. So what they did at that time, a clever step, they told to the Indian tenants, if you want that, you should be free from this one. Like, you should grow indigo, but you should not give us anything. You should sell it in the market or somewhere. You should not give us as our rent. What you can do? You can do the last compensation part, that the squeezing was done. That give the money in advance to us, and later on we will not take indigo as our rent from you. So many of the Indian peasants, they had given the money willingly to come out from that contract. Many were forced to give the money because thugs and all were hired for it. It's written also there. The sharecropping arrangement was irksome, that is troublesome. Peasants had many signed willingly. Those who resisted engaged lawyers. Landlords hired thugs. Meanwhile, the information about synthetic indigo reached the illiterate peasants who had signed, and they wanted their money back. So many had signed, many thugs were came, so people had signed. In between, those people came to know about synthetic indigo also in the market, those Indian peasants. Now they were worried, Englishmen had taken the money from us in advance, now nobody will purchase our indigo also because synthetic indigo is in the market. So they want that money back, that please give us money back, you did a clever step with us. But now when they had given, obviously Britishers would not, Englishmen would not return to them. At this point, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. So now Gandhi arrived. That cave was there where Indian peasants, Muzaffarpur, that lawyers were there. He began by trying to get the facts. So Gandhi reached there, now he decided to have that fact. So he reached to the secretary of British Landlord Association. So he thought, I should go there and take the exact information, because fighting in the court is useless now. But they had not given any information to him because they said he was an outsider. He did not belong to that particular place. So he said that he was not an outsider. He's an Indian only. I don't belong to this place, but I'm an Indian. I'm not an outsider. So information was not given. Next, Gandhi called to the British official commissioner of the Tirhut division, in which Champaran district lay. The commissioner, Gandhi reports, proceeded to bully me and advise me forthwith to leave Tirhut. Now, British official commissioner said to Gandhi when they were at Tirhut division, basically, to leave this place, because they also understood that Gandhiji was like the representative, to leave that place. Gandhiji did not leave. Instead, he proceeded to Motihari area, right? Several lawyers accompanied him. At a railway station, many people greeted Gandhi. He went to a house, headquarters, continued his investigation there. Report came. Gandhi decided to go and thought the next morning he would go. He started out on the back of an elephant. He proceeded. Now he started, next morning he started his investigation and all. A messenger came and ordered him to return to his own carriage. Gandhi complied. Messenger drove Gandhi home, where he served him with an official notice. So it was told him to go back to that place where he stayed there. And a summon was given to the Gandhiji to leave this place. Now this is a conflict of duty, very, very important point. Britishers, English people ordered him to leave this place, otherwise he would be in court. Now, there was a conflict of duties. First, he wanted to fight for the Indian people. Secondly, order had came, how he can, now what he could do for that. So, two things were there. He obeyed because he was the one who believed in all these things. So, he said that, I would not go from this place, I will disobey you. And for it, if you want to give me the punishment, you can give also. But I would not leave this place at all. Conflict of duties. Whether I should help my people or I should leave. Said, I would not leave. I would be here only. I am disobeying you. But you can keep me on the jail for disobeying. Right? So it's written. All night, Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends because all were the lawyers there. He sent instructions to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. Morning found the town of Motihari black with peasants. They did not know Gandhi, recorded in South Africa. They had merely heard that Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble with the authorities. Their spontaneous demonstration in thousands around the courthouse was the beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. This is important. Now, number of people came there when they heard that Mahatma had came from South Africa to help them and he is in trouble with the authorities. Number of people came to support Gandhi that we can't allow this person to be in jail. When number of people came at that time, that was a liberation from fear of the British. That was the Gandhiji realized. That Indian people have started working towards the freedom actually because they all were united now. Right? So next we will continue in the next class. I really hope it's clear to you. Read it once again. Any doubt, ask me. Thank you. God bless you all. Send the work timing.